We have Thelma Snyder in memory of her son, Scott Snyder, as our web sponsor for today. We have a very special person, one of my friends, my dear friend. She's joining us from Hong Kong on our web broadcast, as well as other people out there. I think they're ready to come with the candle. Those who have announcements will please make their way forward.
Good morning, I'm Maddie. I'm the Children's Ministry Director. Coming up this next weekend, we have our Trunk or Treat event. It's on Saturday from 1 to 3. If you're interested in helping, I still have the sign-up sheet. You're more than welcome to sign up. I will send out an email for anyone who did sign up. I'm going to send out an email this week giving just some details and ask a few questions. This is open to all kids, any kids. If you have any kids in your neighborhood that you know might have a blast coming to this, please invite them. It's going to be so much fun. And my other announcement is just if you're interested in teaching children's church this fall through the winter into the spring, so I guess all year. If you're interested in teaching children's church, please let me know. It's a great time for the kids. They really love it, and it gets them out so they can learn something a little different than what we're learning in church. But yeah, thank you.
Good morning. My name is Ivan Cohen, and I do believe myself to be the leader of the SOS small group. So remember all that chicken that we had? Chuck Somerville came up with the idea of doing a chicken and biscuit fellowship. So November 3rd, you guys will be treated to the SOS. Rick, put that snow sign down.
But there was snow this morning.
You will be treated to a chicken and biscuit fellowship. It is donation only. Just remember how good our chicken and biscuit is. So look forward to having you all there and enjoying it. Thank you.
Good morning. I am Mary J. McGraw, and I am myself. I'm nobody else today. It is that time of the year again. I'm going to be setting up for the silent auction for the education fund, and it'll probably run from the 1st of November till the cookie crawl, which will be on December 9th. So mark your calendar, December 9th, and want all your cookies. And the silent auction will be out in the front. And I was at a craft show yesterday, and one of the girls from the Methodist Church there heard me talking about it, and she so graciously donated this quilt. Nice. So this is just one of many things to come. I've put the word out to some of my quilters, and hopefully I'll get more quilts. But there is a lot of nice stuff coming forward for this silent auction. And last year, I don't think I gave you any kind of a report on how much we made on the cookie crawl and the silent auction, but we did make $1,000. So thank you very much for your support and your kind generosity. If anybody has anything they want me to put in baskets or whatever, just see me after church and I'll take any and all donations. And if it doesn't go into my stuff, it will go into the stuff for the golf outing. Yeah, sure. Golf outing. So thank you very much, and you have a good day. Enjoy the snow.
Why, thank you. Good morning. Rich Foltz here on behalf of the First United Methodist Men's this coming Saturday after Thanksgiving. I don't have my calendar on me. I can't remember. The 24th. Is our annual, I believe it's our 8th or 9th annual craft show. The men will be having lunch items out of the kitchen, and we're filling up with crafters, and would love to see y'all there. And if anybody is a crafter and would like a spot, get an application and get it to me or Sandy. Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Jefferson Niles. I'm the pastor, and I am so pleased to see those of you who are here this morning. If we have visitors among us, we welcome you. I know our dear sister who's sponsoring the web ministry today, Thelma Snyder, brought some of her family members. So we welcome you and all who are visiting, all who are joining us by way of the internet. I know my mother is out there somewhere. So I welcome my parents and my sister who are no doubt tuned in at this time. Good to see all of you. Just to remind you that today we will be receiving a special collection in addition to the usual collection we ask you to give towards disaster relief for 2018. I'm sure you are aware of the several places that have been affected by hurricanes, tsunamis, earthquakes, and other disasters. So we want to respond. We ask you to be as generous as you can. Next Sunday, immediately after worship, one of our own, a fireman, who's a member of this congregation, will lead us in a post-worship presentation on fire prevention, fire safety. And we invite as many of you as possible to be a part of that event. I see a hand up there, Mary Jane, who is herself, yes? We. We welcome as much as we can get. Thank you very much. And this is an early notice, but we have a special service coming up next month. It's a little less than a month away. We will be honoring one of the oldest gentleman in our congregation and a World War II veteran. That will be on the 18th of November. So we want you to keep that in mind and plan to be here, tell others about it as we celebrate the life of Mr. John McGrath. Thank you so much. And it is my pleasure to turn the service over to our worship leader, Ed Elsner. Thank you.
Okay.
Rise for the call to worship. Welcome this day to the house of the Lord.
We are greeted in peace and in love.
Welcome this day to the worship of our Creator.
We worship in hope and with grace.
Welcome this day to our community of faith.
We are with our sisters and brothers in Christ.
Friends, let us worship God. Thank you. in this moment. Make fear and worry disappear. In their place, plant truth. You are a God who saves, who loves, who comforts, and who protects. My soul is unassailable. Quiet my mind, so all my focus is on you and your power. Amen. Please say hello to those next to you. Pass the peace of God. It is wonderful to be gathered here with everyone this morning. Yeah. Let us give in courage and confidence without thought for fears of economic decline, our children's education, health care, or retirement. Let us risk love when there is much to fear in the world, and our media and society place fear first. In the house of fear, fear taints our outlook and limits our choices. Consequently, our needs for acceptance, affection, influence, and power determine how we invest and spend our time, our money, and our love. Give us the courage and confidence to live the gospel fully, even when it involves risk. Amen. Children, would please come join me. There may be chocolate involved.
Today, as we prepare for children's time, which Ed will lead, I want to invite everyone to stand, if you are able, as we join in singing, "I've Got a Joy, Joy, Joy Down in My Heart." Remember last week, we had a young man here, Isaac,
yeah,
and he showed us the way we should do it. We should be on our feet, we should be clapping and stomping and really demonstrating that we have a joy in our heart. So stand, please, everyone, and be prepared to clap and dance and sing and shout so that everyone will know that we have that joy in our heart.
Joy, joy, down in my heart. Down in my heart.
Down in my heart.
Down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart.
I got the joy down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart to stay. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. And I'm so happy, so very happy. Thank you.
Welcome. Today we're going to talk about two things. We're going to talk about patience and risks. So if you get more than a few, which I define as three, please pass them on. Just a few. Just hold them. Yeah, just hold them. Well, you know, two or three. Then pass them out to somebody else. Whoa. Yeah, you have to share. Give one to your mom. Okay, now just hold those. Okay. How useful are those, just in your hand? No, they're not. I was originally thinking maybe I'd bring a pumpkin, and, you know, it's not very useful if you just leave it as a big round pumpkin, but if you cut it open, you can do all kinds of things with it. So it's taking that risk that, you know, going and cut it open, try to change it into something else that allows you to make pie, and pumpkin seeds, and jack-o'-lanterns. And God does that with us, just as people by ourselves. We're lovable, we're good, but we can do so much more when we let God open us up. So why don't you take those M&Ms, and what do you want to do with them? You want to put them in your mouth and crush them?
Yeah.
Well, they're not going to be M&Ms anymore then. Oh, really? You think if I take them back out of your mouth after you've crushed them, I can make it back into an M&M?
Ew.
No. It doesn't go backwards. You take the risk and you go forwards. Hot glue it? Yeah, but it's still going to be kind of messy. Well, you'd eventually lose the outside covering and it'd start melting all the way. But that's the thing. With God, we can take these risks. We can go forward and we can do great and wonderful things. So enjoy your M&Ms. Yeah? Oh, if we take it out and crush it, yeah. Crush it in your mouth. That's the best place to crush those. Go ahead.
So bad.
What? You don't need that much candy.
Chocolate.
I beg to differ. Watch, if I walk over here and say, here, take some, pass them down. Take the whole bag and just pass it over to the choir. There, see? I know. We're all good. Everyone, I think, likes a little chocolate, a little sweetness in their life. Thank you very much for being patient. Go ahead. You can eat them now. Bow your heads with me. Dear God, thank you for being patient with us and for letting us be all that we can be, even if it does cause some breakage now and then. But there is so much wonder inside each of us, in every human being. Help us to see that you're good, and your love inside the people we meet every day. Amen.
Amen. Before they go, and I'd like to really thank Ed for that very useful presentation to the children. And you brought up the pumpkin. Remember last week I asked you a question about pumpkins? You remember the question? We wanted to know, what is a pumpkin? Is it, yes, Josie? Oh, it's a fruit or vegetable? Yes?
A fruit or vegetable?
What did you find out?
I'm pretty sure it's a fruit because it has seeds.
It's a fruit because it has
seeds.
Vegetables have seeds. Yes? So we will continue to figure out what it is. In the meantime, let us enjoy all the pumpkins we have around us. And I know today we have pumpkin soup for fellowship time. So you see, there's so many things you can do with pumpkin. Thank you so much. And off you go with Matty to Children's Church. Let us give them a round of applause, please. And please
Let us say thanks to our dear brother Ed for leading us so well today. Brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you. Let us join in prayer. Let us pray. Loving God, thank you for this beautiful, rich, and abundant world which you have created and entrusted to our care as stewards. In our personal finances, Lord, give us wisdom to manage money well and to practice heartfelt generosity. As we live each day, we pray that we will treat this earth gently and receive its goodness with gratitude. We pray to be ever mindful that you are the giver of all we have, and to relinquish pride of ownership and serve freely. We pray today for our politicians, business leaders, and all those who are set in authority, those who manage our economy and have responsibility to care for our environment, that they may be just and prudent. Heavenly Father, your word promises that you know all the material things that we need to live, but we find it hard to trust. We pray now for all those who struggle with the burden of personal debt, for those too frightened to face the problem, for couples who cannot talk about it, for children who cannot understand but live with the worry. We pray also for those who are consumed by money worries, anxious about jobs or homes or the future, those who feel they have lost control of money and cannot cope. We pray especially for those we know or love who are struggling. Heavenly Father, you want us to be a generous people, offering our time, our skills and abilities, and our money to your service. We pray that we will not hold tight when we should be letting go and honoring you as Lord of all we have. We pray for the work of all pastors, the ministry of this and other congregations in our community and overseas, and for those Christian ministries that we support. Heavenly Father, we pray for those known to us who watch or wait or weep today, the sick, those whose names are listed in our bulletin. We pause to remember all such persons, Lord, even the names that are not included in today's bulletin, but those who are known to us, who are afflicted. We pray for them now. The lonely, those caring for others, those finding it hard to care for themselves. We pray for the dying and those who wait with them, and for the bereaved. We remember today, O gracious God, family members of ours in Anguilla who grieve at the death of Samuel Connor. We commend his soul to your gracious care and keeping, and pray for all who have died that they will rest in peace. We give special thanks today, O gracious God, as we remember the late Scott Snyder. On the 10th anniversary of his death on October 26th, and in whose memory Thelma Snyder, his mother, and other members of the family are sponsoring today's web ministry. Lord, we pray that you will continue to comfort and grant them strength. O gracious God, we pray for those who suffer as a result of recent natural disasters, for those in the Florida Panhandle, the Carolinas, Haiti, Indonesia, and other places where people have been affected by natural disasters. We give thanks, Lord, for all who have responded to these situations, and pray that the special offering that we have taken today will help alleviate suffering. O loving God, we rejoice with those who rejoice. We remember in a special way our dear sister, Dr. Hamlin Smith, as she celebrates an anniversary of her birth. We pray for all who celebrate today. We thank you for her contribution and participation in this congregation, and pray that you will continue to inspire and strengthen her and use her and others to your glory. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Amen. And now we shall have the choral anthem, Father, Lift Me Up. And this song is dedicated to all who feel as though they need that special lifting today that only God can give. May God uplift you and inspire you as you listen.
Jesus told me to call, and the
Father, lift me up. Let us stand, my dear sisters and brothers, for the reading from the Gospel. We read Matthew 25, 20 to 28. The servant who had received 5,000 coins came in and handed over the other 5,000. You gave me 5,000 coins, sir, he said. Look, here are another 5,000 that I have earned. Well done, you good and faithful servant, said his master. You have been faithful in managing small amounts, so I will put you in charge of larger amounts. Come on in and share my happiness. Then the servant who had been given 2,000 coins came in and said, you gave me 2,000 coins, sir. Look, here are another 2,000 that I have earned. Well done, you good and faithful servant, said his master. You have been faithful in managing small amounts, so I will put you in charge of large amounts. Come on in and share my happiness. Then the servant who had received 1,000 coins came in and said, sir, I know you are a hard man. You reap harvests where you did not plant, and you gather crops where you did not scatter seed. I was afraid, so I went off and hid your money in the ground. Look, here is what belongs to you. You bad and lazy servant. His master said, you knew, did you, that I reap harvests where I did not plant and gather crops where I did not scatter seed. Well then, you should have deposited my money in the bank and I would have received it all back with interest when I return. Now take the money away from him and give it to the one who has 10,000 coins. This is the gospel of Christ. Praise be to Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Have a seat, my sisters and brothers. Lend power to my words, O God, for I ask of my hearers more than hearing. Let my voice prompt love and compassion, repentance and forgiveness, courage, obedience and commitment. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be found acceptable in your sight. O God, our strength and our refuge. Amen. Amen. Faithful or fearful stewards. Last week, we considered the stewardship of time. We noted that time was among the gifts that the three servants received. With time, they had liberty, freedom, opportunity, but there was also accountability. They had to account for their time. As we continue our reflections on stewardship, which is our theme for this month, and the parable of the talents, let us consider faithfulness and fearfulness in the exercise of stewardship. The word faithful is used to describe the two servants who made gains or added to what they received. Their master calls them good and faithful servants. The third servant, who hid what he received, a hole he dug in the ground, is called wicked, bad,